Now I'm going to focus on how to do a correlation computation with the use of different formula, but today I'm going to focus on Pearson product moment correlation only. Before going to that, just I'm going to the small intro about the correlation. After that, I'm moving to the Pearson product moment correlation. Linear means it's a straight line, this we know. So non-linear, it's representing curve. It's not like a straight line, but linear represents a straight line. Correlation means is a correlation. Correlation, the terms you can easily understand. Correlation. What is my correlation? So relationship between the, what is that, whether the two variables going together or going in different directions. That is called correlations. Here, the correlation, we are going to find the two things. One is called degree of strength as well as the direction. So that things I will discuss in the next slides. The linear correlation means to go together in a straight line. To go together in a straight line. This is called correlation. Now I'm on to the next slide. The next slide is talking about the correlation coefficient is the number that summarizes the directions and degrees of linear relation between the two variables. So in this case, see here, actually we may know these things. Suppose I may get the correlation values minus 0.56. Is represent the minus represent the direction of my relationship of the two variable. That the 0.53 represent the strengthness. So the directions based on the symbol, whether it may be positive symbol, it's called positive. If you get the negative symbol, it calls a negative correlations. But the value represent the magnitude represent the degree of strengthness of this particular two variables. So that is normally we are going to found the direction as well as the strengthness of the relation between the two variables through this kind of Pearson product moment correlation. And the correlation coefficient also known as Pearson product moment correlation coefficients. Some people they called in a short form PPMCC, otherwise PCC, Pearson coefficient correlation. Some people they use the Pearson product moment coefficient correlation, the short form PPMCE or PCC. Like that, some different books having the different things they are keeping. So I move to the next slide. Normally, you may found in the different books that they use the different terms or different kind of symbol for representing the, for denoting the correlations value. Some books they may put as an R, some books they put as a row, but the logic this one only. If you want to highlight, if you find out the correlation for the sample data, sample representation data, if you're finding the correlation, then we can use the term R. R represent the sample correlations. If you found these symbol like a row, it's represent the, this is called row symbol. This is represent only for population, denotes the population correlation value. So from this, you can understand what is by sample denotes the correlation symbol as well as the populations. Now I am moving to the small intro about the correlation and its value. We already know that the limitation or the limit of the correlation value is plus or minus one, but the scores how it goes in the sense minus one through zero to plus one. Actually, zero is called zero correlation. If you found the zero is called zero correlation. This zero to one is called as a positive correlation. Zero to minus one we may call as a negative correlation. So like that, we may categorize the correlations. This side is called positive, right side positive, the left side is negative. If the scores comes plus one, it's called perfect positive. If the scores of the correlation values comes a minus one, it's called a perfect negative. These are things we know. The sign represent here, the plus denotes a positive correlations. The minus denotes a negative correlations. So from this, we can easily write the interpretation also. When the correlation is positive, so these things are greater than zero. As the value of one variable increase, so does the other variable also increase. That is called positive correlations. In this, I'm giving the example also. An average as height of the people increases weight. It means that height, weight, it may go to the same directions. It means that if height increase, weight also increase. Otherwise, height is decreased, weight may be decreased. The same way increase, decrease is going the same way in these two variables, then it's called as a positive. If it go to the vice versa, go to the opposite way, then it's called as a negative correlations. These things we know. Now I'm moving to the Pearson product moment correlation. This is the things I'm going to much focus on today. I already mentioned that Pearson product moment correlation, we called as a PPMCC, Pearson product moment coefficient of correlation. This is an expansion. Then some people, they're using the term Pearson coefficient of correlation or the Pearson SOR. So different people are using different terms. This is a gentleman of Pearson. He's a man. He born in 1857. He died in 1936. He gave the tremendous contribution in the statistics area. These are the things he made it to the society. And his teacher, the great advisor for him, is Francis Galton. He's the inspiration. Actually, he only he developed this kind of the Pearson product moment correlation from this teacher's ideology only. That's why I highlight like this was developed by Carl Pearson from the related idea introduced by the Francis Galton in 1880s. Yearly work also some of the people are dead like Anil Kumar Jain as well as the R.A. Fisher. That you know, the R.A. Fisher is the founder of the F-test and the normally this Pearson product moment correlation is checking the linear relationship only. It's not for the curvilinear. Once you're adopting or once you do for the Pearson product moment correlation, damn sure that relationship will be the linear only. Then only we can use this kind of Pearson product moment correlation. If you have the curvilinear, we can go with other kind of monomial, binomial, polynomial, that kind of correlation techniques we can use. The regression also, it may be there, that kind of things. But while we found the linear relationship, then only you can adopt this kind of Pearson product moment correlation. And the main thing, while adopting the Pearson product moment correlation, the variable, the two variables should be in a continuous nature. So we already knew the scales of measurement, nominal, ordinal, interval, and ratio. So in this, if you want to adopt a Pearson product moment correlation, the variable should be the two variables. The x is an independent variable. The y is a dependent variable. It should be continuous. We already know that the continuous represent interval or ratio. So I am writing like this. The variable should be interval or ratio. So then only we can, do this kind of Pearson product moment correlation. Interval or other thing is called as a ratio. So it means that the variable is to be continuous nature. So this is a conditions we can use the Pearson. And normally the Pearson product moment correlations may lie in the statistics part of parameter statistics. Because normally the sample size may increase as well as the, if you are using this kind of continuous data, we can use the parametric only. Therefore, the Pearson product moment correlations, it may lie on the parameter statistics. It's called parametric statistics. So I'm just writing parametric. This is called parametric statistics. This is parametrics. If you go with this one, rank correlation, it's called non-parametric because we are using as ordinal data. So we may consider this a non-parametric. Now I move to the next slide. So in this slide, it shows the brief history of the Carl Pearson. He born in 27th March 1857, but somewhat assumed as we found. See here the date, birth also 27. The date is same, 27, he born, died also 27. But the year is before, the March, also the month is to be before. He's basically from England. He's a nationality British. He found tremendous contributions, even the principal competent analysis in the Pearson distributions, Pearson R, Pearson chi-square test, pi coefficient, even the one types of correlations called pi coefficients. This much of contribution he's provided to us. And his great advisor, Francis Galton. So he's the advisor as well as the teacher of him. So he's the man. This is a man. It's called, his name is called Francis Galton. That's why I'm given as a Pearson with Sir Francis Galton. So it is none other than the great person called Pearson. So this is an old image, that's why it comes in black and white. Yes, now I'm moving to the next one. Normally, those who are the mathematics people, they probably tell that mathematics is a queen of science. But we could not found who is the king of the science and all. But according to the Carl Pearson, he's defined this kind of definition. Statistics is a grammar of science. It's a grammar of science, but we know that mathematics is here, Kuhn of science, but he proposed that statistics is main for all kind of sciences. That's why he represent, okay, or he suggested, or he denotes that statistics is a grammar of science. So we have to appreciate also for him. And now this is called as a Pearson product, not Pearson product moment college interpretations, general interpretations. We can, if you get this score, if you find the correlation value, after finding the correlation value, we can go this kind of interpretations. Suppose if your score is comes plus one, it is called perfect positive. These things we know. So it means that the same proportion of X is increased, the same proportion of increase happen in the Y. That is called positive. That opposite is called positive negative. So the score is minus one. So these things is no. So it means that if, for example, I'm increasing 10, on constant level, I'm increasing the X value. Parallelly, the Y value may constantly to reduce in the, less in the constant way. It's called the same proportion. It may increase or decrease, but it will be different direction. So X is increased, Y may be decreased in the same proportion. That is called perfect negative. Then if the score is comes to plus 90 to plus 0.99, it's called very high positive. Similarly, very high negatives represent minus 0.90 to minus 0.99. Then next level is called high positive. It is represent 0.70 to 0.90 in a positive value. Similarly, here also high negative represent minus 0.70 to minus 0.90. Then moderate positive plus 0.50 to 0.70. So this is a classification I found from some textbook only. The same order. See here, moderate positive, moderate negative. Low positive, low negative. Then very low positive, very low negative. Negligible positive, negligible negative. The ratio also same, but only the direction may change. That it's nothing but the plus and minus symbol may change. Now the zero correlation or no correlations represent the value 0.0. It represents no correlations. This is a Pearson product moment correlations. Actually, this is we may call as a covariance of X, Y. This is called covariance of X, Y. Normally, we may write like this, n summation xy minus summation x into summation y. This is called covariance of xy. In down, this is called root of standard. This is normally we may know the standard deviation, sigma 1 square, sigma 2 square. So this is nothing but the standard deviations, sigma x and sigma y, that kind of things are using here. The Pearson correlation coefficients, the covariance of the two variable divided by the product of their standard deviation, product. Actually, this is for the standard deviation of X, this is called standard deviation of Y. Their product is called as a Pearson product moment correlation. This is very simple to make it. See here, we have X is the independent variable, Y is a dependent variable. Therefore, I am writing N is the number of sample, N summation XY. Just for memory, I am giving some clue. What you have to, N Y minus, always the minus should be common. See here, everywhere the minus common. If I minus it, we can divide the two. Summation x, y, we had to divide into summation x into summation y. The same logic we can adopt it. Here we are using the two x and y, therefore we are putting summation x, y. But now I'm taking the consideration of the first standard deviation, only x. The second standard deviation, I'm taking consideration only y. See here, n, the same n is coming. Then instead of x, y, you can take instead of y, you can type as an x. What did happen? X into x, x square. Therefore, the same x square happened. N summation x square, the same assumptions. See here, this also summation x. Instead of y, you are substituting summation x. What did come? This summation x, this also summation x. Therefore, it comes as summation x the whole square. There is a difference is that summation x square is different from summation x square. It means that multiplying the x value twice, then after you are adding. But in this case, after adding the entire x value, you are multiplying. There is a two difference or that. Now, previously you added, instead of y, you are adding x. Now we are going to substitute like the same formula, above the numerator. Instead of x, you are going to substitute as a y. What did happen? N summation y square. See here. Now, if you are substituting the same instead of x, if you are typing y, summation y into summation y may happen. Therefore, summation y into summation y is called summation y the whole square. For memory purpose, I am giving this kind of hint for you. But when the people are asking the midnight order, you should be tell the formula. The formula for Pearson product moment correlation R is equal to n summation x y minus summation x into summation y divided by root of n summation x square minus summation x the whole square into root of n summation y square minus summation all the whole square. So don't forget, there is a logic is that the numerator and denominator look like is same. Only the numerator consists of x comma y. The denominator, one part is x, other part is called y. So we can easily make this kind of equation. Now I'm going to directly move to the questions now. Just I'm going to do a solution. I'm going to find the solution for this. This is a question. Actually, I'm going to talk about the direct method only, because now for the examination or you may use the calculator only. Therefore, don't go this kind of short form. I'm going to go with the direct method leading. There's a two methods or direct method or this kind of shortcut method also we can use it to verify, to check the correlations. But I'm going with the direct method because always the direct method is safer side. We could not be get it for some kind of average, but we are not taking the consideration. Therefore, we may get the proper correlation value in this case. This formula we know, R equal to n summation x y minus summation x into summation y divided by root of summation x square minus summation x the whole square into root of n summation y square minus summation y the whole square. Now this is a question, calculate the coefficient coefficient between the age and weight. Therefore, age is a one variable, weight is another variable. I may take it as an age is ax, y I'm taking as a weight. So here x represent independent because age make an influence on the y. Our age may contribute something on the y. So based on the age, only weight may change. Therefore, I'm taking the consideration x as the independent variable. Weight I may take as a dependent variable. So here they given the 5 datas. So if one person having the one age, his weight is 3. The other persons or the are they same person, the age of 2, his age is 4. Then the same person or other person having the age is 3, his weight is 6. Similarly, if the 4-year-old people, old son or guy, his weight is 7. The 5-year-old, he's having the 12 age weight. So therefore, ages comes in years, weight is a kilogram. So here the two kinds of units are there. So even though we are going to compare, normally when you go for comparing the two different units, better to make it a Z-score. But Z-score and all, it's not needed. When you go for a big research and all, you can do the Z-score calculation. But for if here only 5 data, therefore I'm not doing any kind of modification of Z-score and all. We can easily do it. Actually, there is no problem with a different correlation. Because we are going to compare it only. We are going to correlate only. But if you want to check the mean, it's better to go with the Z-score is better. But in this case, it's not needed because even the two different units, because ages comes to years, weight is kilogram. Therefore, no need to be worried about the comparing because whether it's x is increased, y is decreased, or x is increased, y is increased. We can check these kind of things only, therefore no need. Therefore, we have to write age as well as the weight. According to the formula, we need x comma y. Therefore, there is x comma y is there. This formula, we need summation x square also. Therefore, we are finding the x square value. Here also we need a y square value. Therefore, we are finding the y square value. So once you go with x, y, then x square, y square, then x comma y, you can add this all the value. This is called summation x. This is called summation y. This is called summation x square. This is called summation y square. This is called summation x comma y. So it's very simple multiplication only. Then we can apply this formula. We know what is n. Here, please, I request all kindly give the n value. N represent what? Number of samples. In this case, how many samples? 1 sample, 2 sample, 3, 4, only 5 numbers are there. Very good. Surya is correct. There is a 5 sample. Therefore, n value is 5. What is the value of summation xy? The summation xy is 117. Therefore, we are writing 107 minus summation x value. Summation of x is nothing but they add all the x value. It comes 15. Therefore, we are writing 15 here. Then summation of y value is nothing but the summarization of or summary of the y value is called 32. So the numerator, you don't have any issues. The 5 into 117 minus 15 to 32. But in the numerator, once again, the formula is n. Therefore, n I am typing. Summation x square represent this 55. It means that x, then x square, then after that summary. Okay, summarizations, therefore 55, but this is called summation x whole square. What do we have to do? We have to know the value of summation x. Summation x is already, we know 15. Therefore, 15 into 15 is called 15 square. Similarly, the summation, n summation y square is called 5 into 254 minus 32 the whole square. Then we may get that answer like this, 105 divided by root of 50 into 246. If you take the root, then finally it becomes 105 divided by 110.90. If you divide it, you may get that answer 0.9467. 0.9467. Now, please, I request the participants or students, kindly tell whether it's a positive correlation or negative correlation. Is it positive or negative, the answer? Why is called positive? If you are telling us a positive, you have to tell the justification also. Why is called positive? Why is called negative? I request the students kindly give that answer. That answer is here showing the 0.9467. It represents what? It represents what? Is it a positive correlation or negative correlation? Please, I hope all of you get my voice clearly, no? Give a response. Give a response. What is the answer? Yeah, very good. It's correct. Adira is correct. Yes, high positive. Then Anushri is putting very high positive. Exactly. Because even this value is positive, therefore it's positive. But previously we have some table. There the score service comes 0.9 something. Therefore it's called very high positive correlation. Very high positive correlation. It's not only positive. It may be positive. But if you want to write the correct interpretation, you can go with, that's called strength. That is called, the positives denotes the only the direction only. But if you have to tell the strength, what is the strength? Very high. So here the scores, it comes in between plus 902, plus 99. That is shows the strengthness. Therefore, when we go for this kind of Pearson product moment correlation, we may get the two important things. One is called direction. Other one is called strengthness. In this case, the strength is 0.94. It is called very high correlation. Very high. I am putting as a positive, very high correlation may happen here. The same thing, just for I am telling the answers, I am going to compare with the answer only. In the second example, see here, but it's in different way they did. The second example that scores has come 0.92. What it means, it is also called, it's a positive or negative? It's also positive because the symbol represents positive. Here also above the point, and therefore it's called very high positive correlation. Very high positive correlation. So yes, correct. Yes. Now I'm going to do the same thing with the use of Excel. So just because we want to know how we can do this kind of things in Excel. See, I hope all of you get my Excel sheet. Just I'm going to do now. The Excel sheets, age, weight, there is a 5 number. Weight we know, this is a formula we know. First we have to know the x square. What is the x square represent? Just I'm doing the formula here. X square is nothing but 1 into 1. In this case 1 into 1, therefore I am making some b2 then star b2. So what is mean b2 star b2? It means a multiplications. So I'm multiplied by 1 into 1. The answer may comes now. I'm putting enter. Then if you won't go with the other x square, just I'm track it, the other all the x square may comes. Therefore, 2 square, 4, 3 squares, 9, 4 square, 16, 5 square, 25. Now, I found the x square. The x square addition is 55. It automatically comes here. Now, I'm going to the y square. What is y square? It's nothing but y into y. Therefore, I'm going with the formula for Excel. I'm selecting the 3s, the C2 column, and multiply once again C2. Therefore, C2 into C2. I'm putting yes. Then I am going to extend the other scores. Now I get the y square value. It means that 3 into 3, 9, 4 into 4, 16, 6 into 6, 36, 7 into 7, 49, 12 square is equal to 144. So now we understand the y square. This is a summary. This is an entire total, 254. Now I am going to the x comma y. What is x comma y? X into y. So therefore I want to multiply this value with this value. Therefore I am going to here. I'm multiplying the age into the y value 3. So just I'm entering, just I'm tracking the remaining things. Automatically we may get it here. See here, that score 3, 1 into 3, 3, 2 into 4, 8, 3 into 6, 18, 4 into 7, 28, 5 into 12, 16. Therefore, I found all the summation x value. The summation x value, I am writing down. Summation x value is nothing but this value. So just I'm put this in B7. Summation y value is nothing but this one. So therefore, I'm putting this in this formula. I'm starting this C7. Now, summation xy is already there. Summation xy is nothing but this F7 value. Summation x square, this value 55. Summation y square value is 254. I'm just typing here. The numerator value, what is the numerator value? The numerator, the formula is n summation xy minus summation x into summation y. See, that is why the formula, what it, see the formula I'm typing here. Phi represent n, the numerator. Then what is the D12? The D12 represent the summation xy. See here, the summation xy 117 minus summation x summation y is nothing but 15 into 32. If I am putting D10 into D11, if you enter it, automatically the answer is coming here, 105. See the M05. The numerator I'm going to found out. The numerator is nothing but, this is a formula we know, n root of n summation, it's called square root. Therefore, what I'm doing now, see the formula, square root, I'm typing the formula like this, square root of bracket 2 times, first n into summation x square. What is the summation x square in this case? I am writing here as a summation x square is called D7. Therefore, it comes as D7. So now the D7 is coming. Then, D13. Then minus, we may know the x square value, summation x square value. Therefore, x square value comes in here 15. It comes as here D10 column. Therefore, I am saying T10 into D10. Similarly, we can go the next standard deviation of y. I am writing square division of 5 into D14 into D11 into D11. Then if I go with the next, I may get the answer. Denominator is 110.90. See here, I am doing the same. 105 is the numerator. Then denominator is 110. The same answer is coming here, 110. Then finally, the R value. The R value we know, the numerator divided by the denominator. Then if I divide these two, we may get the answer 0.94670. If you go with the two digits, it may come 0.95. Therefore, it shows the very high positive correlation between the age and weight, between age and weight. The same thing, I'm going to be change a different score. Kind of see, I'm going to a different score now. I'm going to sheet 2. Instead of age and weight, I'm changing light height and weight. I'm going with height and weight. I'm already put the formula that automatically comes. For example, height is 70 centimeter. Weight is, I'm talking about the height 171 centimeter. Weight is 81. Then weight is, height is 182, weight is 86, I'm typing like this, 156, the weight is 60. Then I'm typing as a height, it is called the height of the people with weight. So I'm giving the one person height 166, the weight of the people is 70. So the last person I'm typing 156, the weight is 65. So just I'm giving the score. See the answer, x square, y square, x comma y. Then finally, the R value is 0.90. So it represents what? Once again, it's called very high. Just I'm going to do the demonstration with negative correlation. For example, I'm taking the stress as a variable. Then other variable, I may take it as a achievement. Just I'm taking it two variable. I'm changing the scores now. I'm changing stress. For example, normally the stress less, the students may give you more achievement. For example, the stress I'm candidate 50 mark. Achievement is for I'm candidate 100 mark. One student got a 45 in stress. It means that he's very high stress he's having. His mark only 63 only. He's having the 63 mark. Other students having very low 34 only he's having the stress. He's getting the mark 76 something. The other students getting the score he's having the more very high stress. He's very low in the score 60 only. Then other students, he made this course very, he's got only the 23 only, very low stress, but he may get the highest course because the stress may reduce, automatically the achievement may increase. He may get nearly 86. Then one more student also, he got low stress, 25. He's getting more than 90. Now see this question, see the scores. Now why these courses comes negative? Now you have to tell the answer why this course comes negative. I didn't do anything, but the score, see here, there is a negative value. Why is the negative is coming? Please, I request the students kindly give that. What is the logic? It comes a negative because the previous case comes positive only. But in this case, why in the sense? Because the stress is increase, achievement decrease. The stress is decrease, the achievement are increased. That is why I am typing this course. I am typing this code. For example, I am typing both the same. Just I am copying and pasted here what it happened. Just I'm pasting the same as it is here. So I'm pasting, sorry, once again, I'm pasting. Yeah, so I'm pasting the same as it is. The problem, yeah, so I'm typing as it is. Otherwise, it sometimes make an issue because I just a copy and paste, no? That is why it comes some issue. Yeah, now I'm typing the same. I'm typing the same. Just I'm going to summary. I'm going to type the same score. We see what it happened. 34, 48, 23, 25. Just I'm typing as it is. Then I'm going to the score. Here the y square, yeah, the y square value, the entire things should be changed. Yeah, is equal to, yeah, not the here. I can change like this here. This one into this 45. So now I'm going to add this area. Now the parallel I want to show the x comma y also. Therefore x comma y this into achievement score. Yeah, for the example purpose I'm doing. So see here what it happened in this case. Then automatically your scores may change. The score is one. Why the score is one? Because x and y are look like the same. Therefore it's called as a perfect positive. Perfect positive. Now, anyone can tell your score. I will do the demonstration. You can select two variables. Please, I request Surya, kindly unmute your end. Kindly talk to me. You can give some two variables and you can give the scores. I'm going to only five scores only. Give the scores, please. Surya, kindly. Yes, you can tell two variables. You can tell any two variables.
Intelligence.
So, what is the variable? Intelligence. Right. Intelligence. Then, next variable.
Achievement,
very good. So, okay. Now you are containing the intelligent 100 mark, achievement also 100 mark. Okay. Now tell the scores randomly. I can type.
Intelligent score.
Tell me.
50-50.
So, okay. One person 50, that same person 50 achievement. Yes. Yeah. Next student.
Then intelligence 75.
75 achievement.
82.
82. Okay, very good. Next one. Next student.
46.
46. Achievement.
Achievement 50.
50. Very good. Very good. Correct. Okay. And then two more students are there. Please, two more students. Intelligence.
27.
27. Huh? Yeah. Achievement.
35.
35. Right. Next variable. Any last one. Any one data, if please.
82.
Intelligent 82. Achievement.
95.
See, now you can tell without knowingly the answer. You can tell what is whether it's a positive correlation, negative correlation. Answer what it comes. That relation between the intelligent achievements normally is a positive because.
Positive.
Yeah. So now see that answer. The answer also.
0.59.
It's a positive value. But why it comes in moderate level only. So why in the sense? Because some deviations are there. Okay. See the 46, 50, 75, 82. Little deviations are there. That is why it's come as a positive. But it's not a negative. It's purely a positive. So based on the variable also may influence. Suppose I'm going to tell the two variables. You have to tell what correlation may comes. Okay. Now the question, the first variable I'm going to take the consideration. The first variable I'm taking like steady habits. And achievement, whether it may get positive correlation or negative correlation. Steady habits and academic achievement.
Positive.
Very good, very good. So now the next example, steady habits versus what is that? Error. Steady habits versus error in the exam.
Negative, sir.
Very good, because steady habits increase, automatically in the error may reduce. If steady habits decrease, error may increase. Therefore, it's called negative. So I'm so happy because most of the people are understanding. Now I'm going to wind up. So I hope all of you understand now what is by Pearson product moment correlation. The formula is nothing but n summation xy minus summation x into summation y divided by root of n summation square minus summation x the whole square into root of n summation y square minus summation x the whole square. This is a formula only we are using now. Please don't forget this formula. This is a very important formula for Pearson. So when we can use this kind of Pearson product moment correlation, what is the short form of Pearson product moment correlation? PP, Pearson product moment coefficient of correlation, PPMCC, all right? This is a direct method we are using. I'm going to the next slide. This slide is talking about the uses. What is the need to do this kind of Pearson product moment correlation? Correlation used to describe the degree of relation between the two variables. So we could not go with the three variables. If you have the three variables, you don't go with Pearson product moment correlation. We can go with multiple correlation value. The reliability of the test is calculated in terms of Pearson. So when you go for the next semester, you may go for the item analysis as well as the reliability. That time you can use this kind of Pearson formula to standardize your tool. Then even the validity estimate of the coefficient of correlation we are using. Item discriminance power. So while doing item analysis, we can use for the item discriminance power as the one calculation. There also we are using the Pearson value. When you go for multiple correlation, the basic is Pearson only. Partial correlation also is based, it's working with Pearson only. The factor, when you go for factor analysis and all the higher level calculation also, the extension of Pearson only. It's this is like an add-in only. The factor analysis, multiple correlation, partial correlation is like an add-in of the this kind of tool. It predicts the dependent variable on the basis of independent variable. So here we already know that independent variable is a factor. Independent variable is a cause. Dependent variable is a factor. So in this case, we can easily find the dependent variable on the basis of an independent variable. Most of the personality theories are also developed by using this kind of correlation one. Now, if you are highlighting uses, we need to find the disadvantages also. These are disadvantages there while doing a Pearson product moment correlation. As all of you know that Pearson product moment correlation may work with only the linear correlation only, not for the curve linear. Therefore, for curve linear, this kind of correlation is not suitable. Curve linear distributed, we could not use this one. The assumption is taken to the consideration while using this techniques. Okay. Now the distributions of the scores or the two variables should be in a normal. If it is a skewed distribution or a free distributions, we could not use this kind of Pearson product moment correlation. I already mentioned the Pearson product moment correlation is called parametric statistics, parametric. Parametric statistics, there is a three conditions that our distribution should be normal. Then the data may be in a continuous format. The next, the sample size may increase, may high. So these are the condition only we are selecting the parametric statistics. I think you may understand what is my Pearson product moment correlation. Then how to do this kind of Pearson product moment correlation, how to compute the answer for the correlation value through this kind of Pearson product moment correlation. Thank you so much for your passive listening as well as the active participation. I hope it may be very useful for you.